part of Damien's pitch was, I want to do a love story in Los Angeles about Los Angeles.
How much does Los Angeles play a part in this movie? It's enormous.
The way in which LA figures as a character is so crucial to the movie.
First of all, it's called La La Land.
La La Land refers to LA, but also I think it's something bigger than that, and it's a way in which LA is bigger than itself.
It's conflict, and it's compromise, and it's just, it's new every time. It's brand new every night. It's very, very exciting.
Everyone has moved here because they have some type of dream.
Somewhere there's a place where I find who I'm gonna be. Somewhere that's just waiting to be found.
To me, La La Land means having your head in the clouds, not having your feet firmly planted on the ground.
Whether it's acting or directing or music or writing or, you know, journalism, I think people are all here because they love films in some capacity.
I love it.
But sometimes there's a value to living your life in a dreamland. If we didn't let people sort of drift off into whether it's daydreaming or being unreasonable, we'd have no art. You know, we'd have nothing in this world that wasn't purely functional.
Look at Louis Armstrong. You know, he could have just played the marching band charts that he was given, but he didn't do that. What did he do?
What did he do?
Well, he made history, didn't he?
Well, I'm gonna stop auditioning and I'm gonna make history instead.
Well, my work is done here.
Particularly those of us who love film have an idea of what old Hollywood is in our mind. We've seen photos, we've seen films.
The La La Land that Damien is portraying in this movie is a very romantic, stars in its eyes kind of place.
As a movie lover, walking through the city feels like walking through the Roman Forum or the Colosseum. The great monuments of old Hollywood surround you.
That's the window that Humphrey Bogart and Ingrid Bergman looked out of in Casablanca.
Wow.
Yeah.
I can't believe you work right across the street from that.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
The most iconic part of Los Angeles that we were shooting in was Griffith Observatory and the planetarium. It was incredible to be there and to have free reign for a little while. Angel's Flight, which is a ride that's shut down in LA, but they reopened it so we could shoot there. And it was just beautiful.
We got to shoot in some of the cooler music venues. The El Rey Theater, which is where I played my very first LA gig as a headliner back in 2004.
And then we had these other great places that we got to explore that I had never been, like Watts Towers.
The Lighthouse, which is a little jazz club down in Hermosa Beach.
How are you?
I'm good.
Good.
Good. Good to see you.
Great little accidents that happen, too. When you're there, you realize, oh, this is a wonderful-looking pier next to the Lighthouse Cafe.
City of stars, there's so much that I can't see.
And yet it's a city that seems very kind of somewhat, you know, careless and negligent about its own history.
Yeah, so the joke's on history? I don't know. That's LA. They worship everything and they value nothing.
You gotta get to know it and you gotta sort of get off the beaten path and find stuff. And that was what was so fun about scouting this movie. To surprise you as well, and also to try to present the city as a multifaceted organism.
You always try to find locations that aren't shot a million times.
We're looking at an opportunity to do a movie about a city that we care deeply about. We love LA.
There's so many different facets to Los Angeles, and it never stopped.
It's really wonderful to find the locations that suit that thread that is in the film.
And I've been living in LA for 8+ years, and I'm still discovering stuff that I'd never known existed.
The more you live here, the more you see another side of it that you never saw before.
Our Los Angeles is romanticized, but it's grounded in what Los Angeles is and means to people around the world.
You're acting like life's got me on the ropes. I want to be on the ropes, okay? I'm letting life hit me till it gets tired.
Oh.
Then I'm gonna hit back. It's a classic rope-a-dope.
speaks to the duel of Hollywood being both a land of fantasy and wild dreams and where they make movies, and also being a really tough place to live.
I had a very serious plan for my future. It's not my fault. I got Shanghai.
Get Shanghai. You got ripped off.
What's the difference?
I don't know. It's not as romantic as that.
We did want to have our swings and jabs at the versions of LA that I think we all probably despise, whether we live in LA or not.
No.
Come on. What?
But within the span of a movie, to build a love letter from that.
It's a very interesting place because it can be a real land of broken dreams, and I think you see some of that sort of element throughout the film, but it can also be so hopeful, and life can change overnight.
You gotta give it everything you got. Everything. It's your dream.
There's another side to LA that is absolutely stunning, and it's the reason why anyone who's moved here that I know hasn't left.
Look at this view.
I've seen better.
It's the worst.
Yeah.
There's something really magical about the city that takes a little bit of work and exploration to find because it's such a large city. But if you put the time in, you are rewarded endlessly.
It was a way of actually getting to know the city in a way that I thought I already knew but hadn't.
Oh my, Ali can take you.
Okay.
Damien really tapped into something that's very real to anyone who lives here, which is that there's such a romantic history of what seemed like a much more innocent time.
There's no place really like it.
Guess I'll see you in the movies.